What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the BTR Garage. My name is Justin. In today's video, we're gonna be dropping the oil pan on my 2022 GR86. We're gonna check for RTV or silicone in the oil pickup, as well as the oil pan itself. We're gonna take an oil sample to send off to Blackstone Labs for analysis. Let's go ahead and get started. Before we get into the DIY process, if you do have a 2022 BRZ or GR86, I would highly recommend contacting your dealer first to get your oil pickup cleaned out and checked out for this particular condition. If not, you can go ahead and jump into the DIY. Just be aware, this may affect your warranty if you do this yourself. In order to get started, we got to remove the metal underbody panel to get access to the oil pan and the oil drain plug. We're going to start by draining the oil and capturing a cupful of it for our Blackstone oil analysis. It can be a little bit messy, but you do want to dip the cup into the stream of oil. You don't want to capture the very first thing out of the pan. Set that aside, clean things up. We've put a new gasket onto the oil drain plug, and we're going to torque that to 29 foot-pounds of torque. Next, we're going to start removing the bolts for the overpipe that connects to the header. We're going to start removing the bolts that connect the header to the engine block itself. Get them loosened up by hand, and then we're going to get out the power tool to remove them the rest of the way. Don't use the power tools right off the bat. Always remove them or loosen them by hand first. We also have to remove the front pipe from the rear of the exhaust. I didn't show that in the video, in order to get the header to drop there. Once we have that done, we've got the oil pan exposed, and we can go ahead and start loosening up all of the bolts by hand and then removing them the rest of the way with the power tool. Now, the silicone sealant that is used on the oil pan is very, very sticky. It holds the pan on really tight to the engine block. So I'm using a heat gun here. You can use a blow dryer to kind of soften up the glue or the silicone that's holding the pan to the block. And the tricky part here that is a little bit time consuming is getting the pan removed from the engine block. You're going to want to use a little pry bar, preferably one with a wide face. You don't want to use like a screwdriver or a sharp tool, and just patiently kind of pry away at that passenger side corner that I was just prying at, using a plastic tool to hold it open, and eventually you'll be able to get it knocked loose there and then peel it away from the engine block. We're going to inspect the inside of the oil pickup tube here. And you can actually see we've got some silicone RTV jammed up in the oil filter in the pickup tube. So the pickup tube filter is doing its job, but that's also restricting flow as we get more and more silicone stuck up in that tube. Over time, more silicone builds up in that area and restricts flow even more, to the point of potentially causing damage to the engine. So now we'll begin the process of removing all of the old silicone from the engine block itself, as well as the oil pan itself, which actually has a ton of silicone stuck to it. We got to get all of that off and cleaned off so it's nice and clean. You're going to want a few tools, a pick, a putty knife, and some plastic tools as well. And first thing we're going to do is actually clean out that oil drain tube, or the oil pickup tube, by sticking the pick up in there and kind of pulling out the little specks of silicone that is stuck up in there, or the little chunks of silicone. Get those all out of there so it's nice and clean. And this image here shows exactly what I pulled out of my oil pickup. This was only after 4,000 miles. So now you can see it is nice and clean. We have no more silicone stuck up in there. And now we're going after the silicone that's stuck on the face of the engine block, or the mating surface where the oil pan goes. You got to go at this for a little while with your plastic tools. Eventually you'll get it off, and then we're going to hit the same thing on the oil pan itself, peeling away the old silicone, using the plastic tool to scrape away any silicone. You can also use the putty knife here. Just be very careful as you're going through and scraping off the silicone. For the next step, you're going to need a little torque wrench, some alcohol, and some Permatex to seal the pan back to the engine. We're going to use that alcohol on the oil pan mating surface, get it nice and cleaned up, no oily residue. We're going to do the same thing for the mating surface on the engine itself. Ensure that it is nice and clean and dry. Grab your Permatex. We're going to start making a bead around that mating surface on the engine according to the service manual, as you can see in the upper left hand corner. You're going to want to lay that bead all the way around, and I like to put it around the bolt holes as well. Make sure you have good coverage with no gaps in the sealant or the RTV. Once we have a good bead of silicone sealant, we're going to line up the oil pan holes and press the pan into place, and then start inserting the bolts by hand and get them all hand tightened. Once they are all hand tightened, you're going to want to torque them in the manner as described here in this image, or something close to it anyways. I've got my small torque wrench. We're going to set it to 57 inch pounds. That is inch pounds, 57 of them. Very little pressure. And we're going to torque it to that spec per the image that we just shared, the shop manual torque spec. Get everything buttoned up to that spec. Now that everything is torqued, we should be good to go and ready to put the car back together. So we've got the oil pan back on the car. We got that oil pickup cleaned up, all of that gunk taken out of it. We cleaned up the face of the engine where the oil pan seats, got all of that excess silicone off of it. We cleaned up the oil pan itself, got the face of that cleaned up and all of the excess silicone removed, and applied a nice, neat and tidy bead of new silicone on the oil pan area to seal that up. So we should be good for the future and not have any potential problems with oiling or oil pressure on the car. Now, who knows if I would have had any issues to begin with in the state that it was in. I just got back from a 1500 mile road trip where we tracked the car out at Utah Motorsports Campus. 70 minutes of pretty hard track time. Everything ran fine. No oiling issues, no oil temperature issues. The thing was perfect. So, like I said, who knows if there would have been any problem in the future, but I'd rather be safe than sorry. If you're concerned that your own car might have this particular issue, especially if you have a 2022 car, I would highly recommend contacting your dealer first and seeing if they can take care of it for you or will do it at a low cost. If you'd like to do it yourself, hopefully this video will put you on the right track and make the job easy. And don't forget, this process also applies to the older cars. So even the 2020 and older BRZ 86 FRS, the same job will apply to those as they have the same oil pickup and they've even been known to have the same issue. So now we just have to put the car back together, get the header bolted up, the exhaust put back together, all of the under panels put back on, and of course, we've got to put oil back in the car. We'll throw on a new oil filter while we're at it, and we should be good to go and hopefully free of any potential issues that this oil pickup being clogged might have caused in the future. So thanks everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it was helpful. If you have any thoughts, comments, or questions, please leave them down below like usual. I would love to hear from you. Stick around for more good stuff coming up very soon. Stay safe out there. I am checking out, and we'll talk to you all next time.